The Frank Haith Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. And now your host, Bruce Howard.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to the Frank Haith Show. I'm Bruce Howard, joined by the head basketball coach of the University of Tulsa, Frank Haith. And coach, you go on the road, never easy to go on the road at all, lose to ECU, but boy, what a great bounce back victory you had Saturday, huh?
Yeah, we went down to Greenville, and I thought our guys, we ran into a team that was desperate. You know, they had not won, I think they lost 6-7 games in a row, and they were very inspired, and we didn't do what we needed to do, and then we came back home, had a really good win against a Central Florida team that I think is very talented and, you know, right there with us in terms of in the race. I mean, so it was a huge win for us in our building here on Saturday night.
Yeah, no doubt. And you've won 6 out of the first 8 in the league, which is obviously a terrific accomplishment. Really great start for your team in the league, huh?
It really is. You know, I thought the first part of it, I was a little worried about the first way we started the year. With our games, but we've handled ourselves pretty well.
In a moment, we'll be back and we'll talk about University of Tulsa in Greenville, North Carolina against East Carolina. That's next on The Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show, and it's never an easy trip to Greenville, North Carolina against ECU, no matter what their record, right?
No, and you look at their team, they're very athletic, they're very long. So they have a lot of good players that can give you problems.
Yeah, and they also play very good defense, especially at home in Greenville, and that showed up certainly in the game on Wednesday. And in the early going, Sterling Taplin here gets a nice role for you.
Yeah, and you know, they contested his shot, but they guarded him differently than he's been guarded all year. And I think it kind of stunned him a little bit how far they went under ball screens just like that, and they did that most of the game.
This would be one of many shots that Junior Itu made in the game. He was the one guy that really stepped forward for you.
You know, Junior had nice rhythm in this game. You know, he wasn't rushed. He took his time. Right there, you see the 1-2 getting into his jump shot, and you know, really was a thrust for us on the offensive end.
Speaking of jump shots, there's Corey Henderson knocking one down for you.
Yeah, and Corey's another guy. I think offensively did a nice job this game, but we needed more. But that was a good play by him coming off that ball screen.
Dang, Riak with the rebound and the basket, and far too much of that in the game,
I'm sure. Yeah, one of their long players in the paint, you know, and good offensive rebound there by Junior to stick back.
Tied the game up at 12. And then moments later, it'll be the Junior E2 show yet again.
Nice penetration kick by Pat Burke. Fine. Obviously, good looking shot there by Junior. Like I said, he took his time, you know, didn't rush it. And here's where he's just super tough. Here's a guy making threes. Now he dribbles into a post up, and he's got a good mid range. That's what makes Junior so tough to guard.
Yeah, and especially when they don't double team him, he's nice and patient. And there's White hitting a 3-pointer. That was a tough one right at the end of the half. It gave them a 5-point lead.
Yeah, he's one of their best shooters, and we didn't do a good job there. Doing your work early, being there on the catch.
E2 with 13 points in the first half, but the shooting on both sides just simply wasn't good. Was that good defense, bad offense, or what?
Well, I think our offense, they played great D, but I think we had some open looks, Bruce. We just didn't make them. And I think that goes for them, too. They didn't make them either, you know, in the first half.
Martin Zigbanu with a nice physical move.
I thought in the second half we came out with good thrust offensively in terms of being aggressive and attacking. Barkley had not been shooting the ball well, and he got going here in the second half for them, and he's very, very talented.
Yeah, they got into that double-digit lead. They led by as many as 13, but there was a stretch here, Coach, when you were just kind of trading baskets, but you were hanging in.
Hanging in, you know, got our offense going. Good kick out right there, nice shot by Junior, and we really stressed those spot-up threes around the perimeter when we get second shots, opportunities in terms of rebounding the ball. Good pass there and good finish by Junior. I think that was Corey Henderson zipping that ball in there in a high-low look. And, something we want to do with Junior, moving him around. You just saw him make a three before, now post up right after that.
But as you can see, East Carolina still has that 10-point lead. That's a really nice drive.
Really nice drive by Sterling. And the thing I will give our team credit for, we didn't panic.
Right.
We kept playing. You know, really nice drive there by Junior. Clear out for him off the deck. We kept plugging away. You know, we got ourselves right back in the game. You see it's a 10-point lead there with 7 minutes to go in the game, but we have a chance to tie the game or win the game here at the end.
And Corey Henderson starts getting hot for you here.
Yeah, nice pass by Pat Burke, squeezing the defense and then kick out right there.
And you're getting it kind of in the middle of that zone, right?
Yeah, and they went zone late because we got a little rhythm going offensively from the perimeter. Still 10-point lead with 4.5 to go. Huge shot right there.
And you call a timeout. That's the time to kind of regather yourself. And you're, again, down by 8. You get a new possession. What a play by Junior E2, huh?
Yeah, and Junior was fatigued at that point in time. So one reason we called timeout. But heck of a play right there by him, diving on the floor and making the pass to Pat. And good finish by Pat, not settling for a 3 right there.
And, of course, again, you don't give up. And this is a 2. It almost looks like a 3, but he's just inside the arc as Corey hits another one for you. And that knocks the lead down to 5. And here you are. You're right there.
Right where you need to be with the game still in boundary right here. And really nice offensive play by Corey getting that shot off.
And then you are down by 6, but this is a big one for Junior E2. Makes it a 4-point game.
Yeah, good passing, sharing the ball, open look by Junior. Nice drive right here by Jaleel and one, which gives us a chance to get the lead even closer, get close to right there at the end. Good finish.
I was going to say, you got a stop, which was good, and now you're down by just 1 after the free throw goes in, and you get a stop again, and here's your chance to take the lead.
Yeah, and the play was for, obviously, of course, you toe the line right there, but we had an opportunity to drove the ball there, didn't have to settle for that. And we still get a chance here to tie it, and that would have been able to take the lead before. We had the foul. Tough shot right there. We had plenty of time. And Junior's awareness right here, he had time. He could probably look for Corey there in the corner. And then another play there, Sterling should have looked to throw it out, not try to tip it in right there. We still were down 3.
So there you have it, the final score at 69-66. And certainly a disappointment, but not disappointed, certainly with Junior E2's effort, huh?
Junior played extremely well. And like you said, I mean, we knew we were, you know, going on the road, and I think we talked about this. East Carolina is a dangerous team because they're really good athletes. But I thought our guys, fought to stay in the ball game. We just didn't finish it.
And I would suspect that East Carolina will beat some other teams in Greenville the rest of this American Athletic Conference season. So Tulsa comes back home on Saturday, and we'll have the highlights of TU-UCF coming up next. Go!
I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show, and Coach, you know, in your time at Tulsa, you've always been really good at the bounce back game, but this is a new bunch. So to me, this was a big test Saturday against UCF.
A huge test, and against a really good Central Florida team. I mean, very. You talk about length of East Carolina. There's no one longer than the Central Florida in terms of with Taco Fall and their length on the perimeter. And I thought we did a really, really good job. Our mindset was good coming into this game. There you go. You see they play a lot of zone when Taco's in the game. We really attacked the hot post there with Junior. Martins did a great job starting the game defending Taco Fall, and then there he is getting off his rebound, stick back over Taco.
Yeah, and a 7-0 start, good start for the Hurricane. TU coming in 5-2 in the league, and UCF a half game back at 5-3. And there's Jahleel Wheeler. How important was that for him to hit it? He hadn't hit a three in a long time.
And it was really important because he's a capable three-point shooter, and I was good to see him get a good look and obviously make it. There's TK, and we'll talk, I'm sure, about him a lot more here late, but getting us an extra possession and then finding Junior with a nice pass. And then Junior finishing over the big fella. And I thought it was key. That might have been Taco's second foul, which was key to us keeping him off the floor.
Yeah, he came out of the game after that, and you continue to roll, and there's the jump shot by Corey Henderson that you needed.
You know, Corey got going here in the first half. I think he makes three threes, but there he makes a nice cross-court pass at Pat Burton transition.
So Burt knocking that down to tie the game at 20. Moments later, TK Adoghi.
Nice execution on an OB under, zone play, Sterling makes a really, really good pass. Nice screen by Pat on the backside there.
Yeah, that pass is not an easy one to make, and it was perfect. And there's another three-point opportunity.
Against the zone, we hit the short corner with TK, nice find, the Junior diving down.
And there's Corey Henderson, who really looked like he was in rhythm. That was the second of three three-pointers in the first half for him.
Almost where that three would have been for the East Carolina game, right there at the top of the key, just a little bit closer. Good shot by Corey.
So you start to pull away here in the first half. Travis Hadson made a very good play there.
Yeah, and really good hustle play and finding Will, and Will finishing in the paint there.
Here's a good effort at sharing the ball, and it results again in Corey Henderson's third three.
Yeah, just one more. Nice, no hesitation by Will on that jump hook, but good offensive stick back by Junior.
And a good, really a good game for Will to get his confidence back, wasn't it?
Yes, and we want our big guys being aggressive, and Will and TK and Martins, I think, all did a great job.
And here's Will finishing for you.
Nice setup by Sterling. Penetration and Will going to the basket and a real good finish.
What do those numbers show you there? Obviously, you're shooting at about 45%. Surprisingly, UCF at 50 at that point.
Yeah. Even though I thought you were playing hard defensively.
We were playing hard defensively, but, you know, they turned the ball over 10 times. And so there we had opportunities. Obviously, that's where the reason the score is where it is, even though they shot 50%.
And you look at rebounding, Tulsa was down, but you were battling against a team that was plus 11 on the rebounding side.
Yeah, and we came out in the second half, and then Pat makes these two threes, and both our execution against their
their zone. We figured they would be in with Taco in the game and really good execution on both of those.
So you take a 9-point lead off of that, and then UCF calls a timeout, and then they go on a little bit of a run. At one point, they would take a 57-51 lead, but this was the kind of the high water mark early in the second half for you.
Yeah, and they're a good team, so you know they were going to be able to, they were going to make a run. That was a nice pick, and that whole possession there was one of our better possessions in the game in terms of ball movement, player movement, and we finished with a nice jump shot there by Corey.
As you can tell, UCF has made their run, but Joseph Battle comes in and gives you some good minutes.
He really did, Bruce, and he made two little floaters there in the paint. Well, we were struggling offensively a little bit and got us going.
And that guy right there, B.J. Taylor, hit two or three three-pointers in the second half, and that made it 55-51. They got up by as many as 57-51, but back your team comes.
Yeah, nice play by Jaleel. Obviously, we had good pressure with our trap, and B.J. loses the ball right there, and a good finish by Jaleel once he steals this ball.
Yeah, once Jaleel gets the ball in this situation, he's going to take it right to the rim.
Yeah, and he's a tough guard because he's got the step-through moves, he's got good strength going to the basket right there.
So that gave you a 2-point lead, and now you're up by three. What a play.
Great spacing in our flow game, our two game, which is our pick and roll stuff, and really good find by Corey and a good finish by TK.
And I thought that was the harder dunk for TK of the game, that he had two or three of them, and there you have Jaleel again.
Good execution in our movement offense, and then he attacks the closeout, real good finish through defense.
Jaleel giving Tulsa a bigger lead, and then this will be kind of the capper here for you, Coach.
Good read by TK. We knew Matt Williams was a guy they were looking for. Good switch out on that, and good finish.
And you knew once he tipped it into the backcourt and was all alone, you knew what was going to happen, right?
As long as he could stay in bounds, that was the biggest concern right there. But good finish, obviously, and good athletic play by TK.
Yeah, TK Udogie had a terrific game for you in a lot of different areas, and that's nice to see. Pat Burt with a really good defensive play to end the game and say, hey, we're not going to give up anything here late.
No, and it was just a really good win by us, and I thought our guys showed great toughness, you know, coming back from a tough loss at East Carolina, you know, really good mindset in our practice, and just a good win. You know, you see they shot 50% in the first half. We ended up shooting 41% for the game, which I thought was really good. But I don't think our numbers out there, but we shot 28 free throws, made 24 of them, and I thought that was key to winning that ball game.
And the Hurricane had four players in double figures, and TK Udogie had 10 and 7, huge coming off the bench for you.
Yeah, and add that with our other two post guys, Martins and Will, I think we had great production out of that position.
So the Hurricane winning by 11 over UCF. In a moment, we'll be back with more as we continue. Our feature segment is coming up next on The Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We welcome you back to the Frank Haith Show on the Don Thornton Cadillac feature segment. Well, it was a good month of January, 5-2 for the Golden Hurricane. And here's a look at the top 10 plays of the month of January for TU.
And they're trying to make Tulsa shoot the three, and Tulsa's trying to get to the basket. Burt, top of the key, has a three on the way. Good, Burt, top of the key, three for Tulsa. 14 for Burt. Tulsa leads 68-65, 2:40 to play. Wheeler veers to the right, now backs it off. Throws to Henderson, top of the key. He fires a three-pointer, got it! Corey Henderson, top of the key, three off the double pick, and Tulsa's back to a double-digit lead, 70-59, and a timeout called. The left side, Taplin. Taplin drives left baseline all the way in, loops it to the right side to Henderson. Here comes a three. Side of the rim, no good. And the rebound slam dunk by Igbanu. Holy smokes. Martins Igbanu with a rebound slam for TU. Golden Hurricane leads 71-64. Here's Taylor throwing left side. Ball tapped into the backcourt and stolen by Edogie. Down court, two-hand slam. A two-hand slam dunk by Edogie after a steal. 30.5 seconds to go. It's Tulsa 73-64. 13 to shoot, 123 in the game. Taplin between the rings, passes to Itu. Itu gallops into the lane, hits a layup, and he got fouled. Count the basket. Itu circling around. He cut right down the middle, and he got fouled by Diedrich Lawson. That is the fourth foul on Lawson. Count the basket, and TU leads 73-69. For Tulsa on that break. Driving left, Taplin. Taplin hesitates, throws left corner, Burt. Here's a three on the way. It's good. He got fouled. Count the basket. An opportunity for a rare four-point play for Pat Burt. Off the rim, no good. And the rebound, Wheeler. Here comes TU down by four. 1:06 to play. Wheeler, top of the key. He drives. He draws the foul. Layup. Good. He got it. Holy smokes. Wheeler somehow went inside. Got the shot to go. He drew the contact. Made the shot. And Shepard has committed his second foul. It is 67-65 with 1:02 to play. Wow, what a comeback for TU. Taplin out front with the basketball. He drives to the right, now spins, goes all the way in, layup, miss, rebound, slam dunk, TK Edogie. Edogie with a slammer off the rebound. Tulsa 71-69. What a play by TK Edogie. First, TU by two.
He just seemed to hang in the air for almost 3 seconds to grab that rebound.
And the game is tied at 68. Taplin deep, 13, 12 seconds to go. Taplin brings it up court. Taplin across half court, 8 seconds to play. Taplin angling to the right. He drives to the hoop, layup, yes, with 3.9 seconds to go. Taplin hits a layup, no timeouts for Temple. Inbounds pass to Alston on the right side. Long three-pointer, air ball at the buzzer. Tulsa wins 70-68. The Golden Hurricane wins here at Temple on a Taplin layup. Throws to Edogie, top of the key. Off to the left to Taplin, fires a three, yes! Sterling Taplin with a huge three. He has a new career high 18, and here he has a steal. Taplin dribbles down court. It's a three on one. He lobs it. Slam dunk by TK Edogie. Taplin got the ball to Edogie. Edogie slammed it down through.
Well, there you have it, Coach, the top 10 plays of the month. What ones kind of stick out to you?
Well, there's a lot of good plays there, but the one that stuck out to me was the one at Temple, you know, with Sterling, the game on the line, the play he makes the drive to the hoop. That was a huge, huge play.
Absolutely, a game winner on the road against Temple. We'll be back with more as we continue on the Frank Haith Show. We'll talk about the week to come.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds. The kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Hayes Show, and what a week coming up. At home, that's the great part. Wednesday against Cincinnati, and then Saturday against SMU. Cincinnati is a load. They're ranked 14th now, and they deserve it.
They do, and I think SMU is a top 25 team, too. So, huge week for us, and I look at it as, Bruce, just a great opportunity. You know, we got a chance to play two teams that are on top of our league, but two teams are two of the better teams in the country. So, tremendous opportunity. Cincinnati is just... they're talented. They shoot the ball so much better than they did last year. They're always very physical. And there's no question, we beat them in here last year, and I can anticipate what kind of, you know, fight we're going to get out of them come Wednesday.
And by the way, Upper Bowl tickets available for $5, so there's no excuse. Come on out, 918-631-GO-TU or TulsaHurricane.com. Big home crowd makes a difference, doesn't it?
It does. It, you know, obviously, it helped us the other night in terms of their energy. But let's fill that seat, those seats on Wednesday night.
Absolutely. Wednesday, Saturday, we'll see you at the Reynolds Center. Wraps it up for The Frank Hayes Show. I'm Bruce Howard. So long for now.
The Frank Hayes Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. The Frank Hayes Show has been a presentation of Golden Hurricane Sports Properties and a King Vision production.